really that tragic though, Helena. I mean, the audience obviously loved them.
Well, Natalie, I think this enjoyment was due at least in part to the excitement and extravagance of the shows.
Right, just like today's talk shows, hosts keep the audience entertained by being funny.
Hey, that reminds me, Valerie, good point. That reminds me of one of my favorite talk shows, Jimmy Fallon.
Helena, Valerie, I think we are getting off topic.
Audrey's right. So what are we talking about again?
An excerpt from Gladiator, written by Richard Watkins. Basically, the gladiatorial games talked about in the book are about innocent people who are brutally slaughtered by fighting other humans or wild animals to the death for absolutely no reason at all.
Whoa. Let's not jump to conclusions just yet. What are we talking about? What's the prompt?
Well, I guess our main question is, how did the power of the Roman people influence its leaders and their decisions regarding gladiatorial games?
So basically, how did the people use their power to affect the games?
Wait a second. Wasn't it only the emperors who influenced the games? I thought the Roman Empire was a dictatorship.
It was a dictatorship, but even dictators are likely to be influenced by their people. They want to gain political popularity from their citizens to be able to make their own laws, right?
I agree. A quote from paragraph 2 also proves that point. It became clear that an ambitious Roman could buy a crowd's attention, ensure his social standing, and demonstrate his power over life and death. The citizens were the ones who chose their leaders and decided who they were, right?
But the emperors were the real decision makers. They were the ones who allowed the games to start anyway.
But would they have gone on if no one had attended the games?
The emperors were viewed as gods and looked on as role models. Wouldn't they have an influence on the audience and how the games lasted?
Can you give an example of this?
While there's North Korea, Kim Jong-un has absolute power and control. No one can resist.
Moving on, guys. We're not talking about North Korea. We're talking about ancient Rome. So what eventually stopped these gladiatorial games? The emperor or the Roman people?
In the end, it was a Christian monk, Telemachus, who stopped the gladiatorial games by jumping into an open arena to separate two combatants, resulting in his death. In paragraph 10, the text states, in response to this ugly incident, the Emperor Honorius immediately and permanently banned all gladiator combats.
So it's this incident, not the Emperor, who ended the games. The monk was the cause of the Emperor's decision.
How did monk have the power to stop something when the Emperor couldn't?
This incident could have led people to believe that the games were actually very brutal. From a Roman civilian's point of view, it's like, oh no, a fellow Christian actually died, not some prisoner of war.
There's evidence for this too. On paragraph 8, the text states, these converts began to realize the pain and terror was at odds with the gentle and merciful words of their new religion.
Fellow Christians realized what's happening in the gladiatorial games. This realization caused them, or at least the monk, to rebel and change the emperor's decisions.
I agree what you're saying, but I also believe it's the leader's moral and ethical beliefs that can play a part in this. You have to strongly believe in what you're doing. Maybe with a different leader at this time, the gladiatorial games would have stopped.
All of the crowd loved the gladiatorial games too. And when Emperor Honorius enforced the law to ban the games, he probably grew pretty unpopular, right? Because he took away a free public show that everyone loved to watch.
And I think that it took a lot of courage to enforce this law. And that's what some of the other leaders lacked, because they cared more about political power and popularity instead of doing the right thing.
So now let's answer the second part of the problem. Since Rome has often been compared to the U.S., how does this all relate to society today?
Well, for example, even though there are bad things going on in this world, there are still some people who continue doing the wrong thing, even though it's not helping others.
All for the purpose of gaining political power and popularity. But wait, isn't the government still killing criminals today?
Yes, we still have the death penalty today. It's on a larger scale, but if you put it that way, yes, we're still killing people today.
I was actually wondering about that too, so I looked it up. There's a death roll penalty today, but the death serum is supposed to be painless and free. In this case, with the gladiatorial games, these people are wounded with lethal weapons, but hundreds of people are watching this. That's the difference.
We have to take into mind that the Roman government was corrupted, enforcing unjust principles into the society and in the minds of its people. When you've grown up with something your entire life, you probably will believe it's normal.
That explains it. The Romans may not have realized the brutality of the gladiatorial games, which is why they might not have stopped it sooner.
So the Roman Empire spread propaganda, saying that the games were regular and normal. This makes sense, since countries still use propaganda today to influence their citizens.
That makes sense.
So any other questions?
Okay, great discussion. Now if you excuse me, I have a fencing lesson in 10 minutes.
Wait, Natalie, are you learning how to fence so you can participate in the gladiatorial games? You know, they're illegal now, right?
Unless the president makes it legal again.
Don't you mean the people?
Oh no.